Hello, my name's David, and in this video we're going to create a panorama. So we're going to start by heading up to File. We're going to go down to New Panorama. That opens this dialog. Now the first thing we need to do is add some images. So going down to the Add button, when we click on this, navigate your way to where you keep your images. You can have as few as two, or you could have as many images as it takes to make up a full 360. Now, the images we're going to use are these. They originally started off as raw files. I've taken them through the developer persona, saved them as JPEGs just to make life quicker and easier. There is our first one. Let's click on our second. Press, hold down Command or Control. And holding down Command or Control, there's our third. There's our four images. I'm going to click Open. Going down to Stitch Panorama, which no, it doesn't stitch the panorama, but it will give us a preview. Now the general rule for shooting panoramas is to use it in the portrait mode, as I've done here, and to allow about a third overlap, but I've slightly overdone it because you can see that cloud structure here and here. So we could switch this off. You could go down to Stitch Panorama. As you can see, it looks exactly the same. So yes, we could use this one, but when I had a close look at the one where I used four, it's shown as one of the faults that can appear. So I'm deliberately going to use this one with four images. Let's go down to OK. And when it opens, you can see there's one, there's two, there's three, there's our four images blended together. Looks absolutely great. Right, coming over to the toolbox, first thing we need to do is deal with some of this transparency, and I emphasize some. I'm just going to come to the side. Going to bring it into that position. Just want to leave that person on the side. Let's come across to the other side. Bringing it into that position. Looks pretty good. And clicking to apply. I am deliberately leaving the top, the bottom, as well as those little bits on the side. Looking at the image, this is the one fault that I found by using four images. We've got a step in the horizon. Let's zoom in. Command 1, Control 1. You can see there is that step. Now to deal with this, we're going to head over to the toolbox and we're going to pick up which has got to be the longest name tool, which is the Add to Source Image Mask tool. L is the shortcut, a lot shorter than using the full name. And if I click on this panel here, that is what's been used from image number one. The grey area is where it is masked. If I click here, there's our image number two, and you can see it's used this portion of it. This is the part which is masked out. That's the area we need to deal with. So I'm going to zoom in. I'm going to use spacebar. Now Command or Control. Let's come into this area here. Note the way that this grey area is coming virtually straight down. And if I just reduce the size of the brush using the left-hand square bracket, let's go across where that step is, like this. And if we head up to Render, just waiting for a few seconds, there it is. That has now corrected that step in the horizon. Okay, if I just click down, notice the way it's now taken out this big chunk just to correct that. So it's done a really good job. While we're here, let's press C on the keyboard. That gives us the crop tool. You can see the way the horizon is sloping. I'm just going to move my way across a little bit. With the crop tool in place, you've got the straighten tool, which you can access from the menu bar, or try just pressing Command or Control. Notice the way the crop tool disappears. Here is our straighten tool. So coming to the horizon, clicking down, I tend to lift it up. Let's come across to this little peninsula here and just bringing it down onto the top of the sea. There, it's just swung around. That looks much better. Command 0, Control 0 to go to fit on screen. Pressing H on the keyboard is going to give us the hand tool. That looks pretty good. Okay, let's head up to apply. We're going to go across now into the photo persona. Let's have a look at dealing with those transparencies to the top, the bottom, and the little bit of the wedges on the two side. We're going to head up, if it stays still, let's go back out to fit on screen. We're going to go to select. We're going to go down to alpha range and we're going to go to select partially transparent. Now this will only work by using the select alpha range partially transparent. It won't work using the one tool, and you can see there it is. There is our selection. The next thing we need to do is to head up to Edit, and we're going to go down to Inpaint, and this does a fantastic job. Clear blue sky here, doesn't matter if you've got clouds, try it on the foreground as well. It can do an amazing job. If it doesn't quite work out, just go back to Edit, just go back to Inpaint, give it another try, give it a third try, and it should work for you then. I'm going to use Command D, Control D. There it is, looking absolutely brilliant. Now, if you want to give your image a little bit more of a panorama look, and this works if you've used, say, two images, three, four, as I've done here, and you've still got a photo-dimensional look to it, what I tend to do is go to my snapshots. Yes, that's why this panel is open. I'll take a snapshot. I'm just going to leave it with the date and the time. Right, next we need to press C on the keyboard to give us the crop tool. Let's bring it up from the bottom like this. Let's come to the top. I can drop it down onto that cloud structure like this. And if I double click, and if we come back down, let's take another snapshot, save it, put it aside. That way you can always come back to it, highlight it, click on restore snapshot. You can go back to the original format, or you can go to the, there it is, our panorama, entirely up to you. I'm going to go back with this one. After all, we did work extremely hard filling in the top and the bottom. So there it is. That is creating a panorama picture. Some of the problems you may come across as well. So I hope you've enjoyed the video. Give it the thumbs up if you have. Don't forget to subscribe. Plenty more videos to come. Click that little bell icon. You'll receive a notification every time a new video is posted. But until the next time, it is happy imaging and take care.